Hello my dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. In today's lecture we are going to learn the addition and subtraction of the decimal. Okay, till now we have learned the basic concept of the decimal in the expanded form of decimal, equivalent decimal, like and unlike decimals, right? Moving forward, now we are going to learn how to do the operations on the decimal. Operations means addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Okay, so first in this lecture we are going to learn addition and subtraction. Okay, it is very easy. Just one precaution you have to take, that see, when here two decimals are given, while doing addition or subtraction, what we have to do first, if they are unlike fractions. Yesterday we have seen like and unlike fraction. Okay, unlike fraction means if their decimal places are not same, then first we have to make their decimal places equal. That is, we have to make them like fractions. Okay, before adding or before writing vertically, first we have to make them like fraction if they are not. Understand? Okay, so you know how do we make unlike fractions, or how do we convert unlike fractions to like fraction? By putting zeros at the end, we balance the decimal places. Now see here, 2.732, here 3 decimal places are there, and here 14.08, there are 2 decimal places. So here there are 3, here there are 2, so we have to add 1 zero here at the end. Okay, done. After doing that, let us write them vertically. You know, for addition we write the numbers vertically. This number we write up, plus this number, second number we write down. Okay, in that way. So you see, 2.732 plus. Understood what we have done? First, this first number I have written here. Now, while writing second number, see what we have to do. First, this decimal place write exactly below this decimal place. What we have done? This decimal place, no, decimal point we have written exactly the above decimal, below the above decimal point. Okay, now this whole number, how it will come? This 4 is at 1's place, it will come below the 2, and 1 will come here. Okay, understand? And then 080. See, each digit should be in their places. Okay, so now we have to add as usual, as we add our regular numbers. Okay, so 2 plus 0, we have to start adding from back side again. 2 plus 0, 2. 3 plus 8, 3 plus 8, 11. 1 will come down, 1 will be carried. Rest all rules of additions, addition are same. 7 plus 0, 7, plus 1, 8, correct? Then here write decimal point. 2 plus 4, 4, 6, and this 1. So the answer is 16.812. Understand? Once again I repeat what we have done. First, we have converted them into like fractions by putting 0 wherever necessary. Then we have arranged them vertically. While arranging vertically, decimal point should come exactly below each other. Okay, in one line, in one column. Understand? And then accordingly we have to write the digit below each other. See the second one, 26.99 plus 18.206. Now if you observe here, in this first decimal number there are 2 decimal places, whereas here 3 decimal places. So first we have to make them like by putting 0. Where we will put 0, in the first or second? In the first decimal here. Okay, so now see, if though we have put here 0, their value, its value doesn't change. Understand? Now let's write the first decimal here. 26.990 plus, first write decimal point here, again I am telling, first write decimal point here. Then this whole number 18 is there, so in that 18 write 8 here and 1 here. and then 206. 20 means 206. And then add. 0 plus 6, 6. 9 plus 0, 9. 9 plus 2, 11. 1 will come down, 1 will be carried here. Decimal point. 6 plus 8, 14. And 14 plus 1, 15. 5 will come down, 1 will be carried. 2 plus 1, 3 and 1, 4. Remaining all rules of additions are as it is. Okay. Next, third one. See here, first decimal 4.762 plus 62.08. Here, 3 decimal places are there. Here, 2 decimal places are there. So, let's put one zero here so that it will both will become like decimals. Okay. Now, they have same decimal places. Let's write them down. Plus, first write decimal point. Why, you know, why to write first decimal point? Because some student, what they do, you know, 4.762, then 62.080 is there, so they write this way, 62.080. Is it proper arrangement? No. Decimal point should come exactly below each other. This is not proper arrangement. So first write decimal point here, then here 2 and then here 6. Okay? And then 080. 080. Add. 2 plus 0, 2. 6 plus 8, 14. 4 will come down, 1 will be carried. 7 plus 0, 7 and 1, 8. Decimal point, 4 plus 2, 6. And this is, so 66.842. Okay, next. 4.14 plus 254.5. Now see the decimal places, here 2 decimal places are there and here only 1. So let's put 1 0 here so that both decimal numbers will become like decimals. Okay, now let's 4.14 plus, first write with this decimal point here. Then see, 254 is there. So this 4 will come exactly below this 4. Then 5 and here 2. Okay. Because see, this 4 means 4 ones. There is no tens and 100 plus in this. Okay. So you can write 0 0 there if you want. Then here 5 0. 4 plus 0, 4. 1 plus 5, 6. Point. 4 plus 4, 8. Here no n number plus 5, 5 and 2. 258.64. So in this way, we have to add the decimals. Same rules are there for subtraction also. Subtraction of decimal. First, we have to make them, convert them into like decimals, and then we have to arrange in this way. Decimal points should come exactly below each other. Okay, in this way we have to arrange and then we have to subtract. Understand? So now pause this video and write these 4 examples in your notebook. Remaining 2 examples you have to try by yourself. Got it? Let's learn now the subtraction of decimal. See here, once again I repeat. First, we have to make the both decimals like. Means we have to make the decimal places equal, and then we have to arrange vertically and then we have to subtract. Now see here, subtract the following: 42.6 from 852.449. So from these we have to subtract. This means this is greater number, the number, decimal number which is written after from, this is greater and this is smaller. That means from these means this will come up and this will go down. Okay. See, whenever it is given like this, subtract 42.6 from 852.49. That means this number will come up. The number which is written after from, it will come up and this first number will come down. Or you can just simply compare, this number is greater, this number is smaller. So we subtract smaller number from greater number. So greater number come up. Understand? Now first we will make them like decimals. Here there is one decimal place and here two decimal places are there. So we will put zero here. Okay. Now let's write the big number of 852.49 minus. First write decimal point exactly below the above decimal point. Then 42 means 42 and here 60. Okay. 9 minus 0 is 9. 4 minus 6 not possible, correct? 4 minus 6 here not possible because 4 is smaller. So as this is not possible, so from these two we can take borrow here. As our regular subtraction, we can do subtraction here also. Cut this 4 right up. 4 will become 14, these two remain 1. Got it? Understood what I have done? 4 minus 6 was not possible, so from these two we have taken 1 borrow. So this became 14 and here remain 1. Okay? Now 14 minus 6 is 8. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 8. Okay? So 14 minus 6 is 8. Now here 1 minus 2, is it possible? No, because 1 is smaller than 2. So for that, from this 5, let's take 1 here. So 5 will remain 4. Okay? Then 11 minus 2 is 9. Before that, write this decimal point here. 4 minus 4 is 0 and 8 as it is. So 809.89 is the answer. Next, 14.9 from 432.07. So from this, we have to subtract this. Before that, let's make them live decimals here. One decimal place is there and here two decimal places are there. So let's put one zero here. Now their decimal places became equal. So this number write first. 432.07 minus, first write the decimal point, then 41. Okay? And then 90. Got it? Now 7 minus 0, 7. 0 minus 9. What is 0 minus 9? Is it possible? No. Then from this 2, 1 we will take borrow here, cut this 0 right up. 0 became 10, this 1 became 2 became 1. Okay? Now 10 minus 9, you know. 10 minus 9? 1. Point. 1 minus 4? Not possible. Then from cut this 3, take 1 borrow here. And 3 will remain 2. 11 minus 4. 11 minus 4 is 7, correct? 2 minus 1, 1 and here 4. 470.17. Next. 2.961 from 82. Okay. So let's put 1 0 so that here also 3 and here also 3, they will become like decimals. Now greater number is this which is written after from. So this number will come first. 167.820 minus, first write decimal point, then here only 2, so it will come in the ones place, correct? And 961. See here. 0 minus 1. Is it possible? 0 minus 1? No. Then from these 2, take 1 borrow here. 0 will become 10 and 2 will remain 1. Okay, now 10 minus 1? 9. Again. 1 minus 6. Is it possible? No. Then from 8, take 1 borrow here. 1 will become 11. 8 will remain 7. Got it? So 11 minus 6? 5. And 7 minus 9? Again not possible here. So from this 7, take 1 borrow here. 7 will become 17 and this 7 will remain 6. Okay? So 70 minus 9? 8.
decimal point 6 minus 2 4. Yeah, 6 minus no any number means 6, no 1. So 164.859. okay. Next, 24.94 from 160 from 0.54. Here two decimal places are there, and here also two decimal places. That means already they are live decimals, not need to put zero. Okay, so let's write the data number here. 160.54 minus point first, and here 4, here 2, 9, 4. 4 minus 4, 0. 5 minus 9, not possible. So we need to take borrow from this, but here there is 0. Understand? So first from this 6, we will take one borrow here. This 0 is written up. 5 and 6 will remain 5. Now from this 10, we will take one borrow here. Cut 5, right? 5 became 15. 10 will remain 9. Okay? So now 15 minus 9. What is 15 minus 9? 6. Okay? Decimal point. 9 minus 4, 5, 5 minus 2, 3, and here 1 as it is. So the answer is 135.60. Understand? So in this way, we have to do the subtraction of the decimals. Addition and rules of addition and subtraction of decimals are same. First, what we have to do, we have to make them live decimals. Then we have to arrange them vertically. While arranging vertically, we have to take care that decimal point should come exactly below each other. Okay, and according to that, other digits should be arranged. Understand? So we take care that, otherwise addition and subtraction is same as the common numbers or regular numbers. Okay? Remaining two examples from both the questions, you have to practice by yourself. If you have any doubt in that, ask me. Okay, so thank you and have a nice day.